how can you identify somebody that's a fake guru in the real estate industry based on what you've seen so far on social media?
These fake gurus, there are more fake gurus than there are actually real guys. There are guys on social media that give some good information, okay? And there are some guys that are, in Yiddish, we call them ganefs, which means a thief, a crook, okay? And that's what motivated me. When I saw there's a guy down here in Florida, he has a Section 8 course, and he charges between $50,000 and $100,000 to show you how to buy 5 Section 8 properties with your own money and your own financing. And the value proposition is the cost of a turkey sandwich. I mean, it's just, it's disgusting. And he's also a buddy with a guy with the orange Bugatti, which, if you know, anybody that would spend that kind of money on a car is definitely missing something. You know, maybe their father didn't tell them they loved them that much. I don't know. I was blessed with a great mother and a great father. But there are some guys out there that are not good. And there are some guys out there that are really, really good. And there's a guy, I think he's in Fort Lauderdale. He goes by the name of Tom Cruise, not the actor, who's my hero. Pretty amazing. He's still done stunts.
Love his movies.
I want to say the guy's probably 60 or something like that. But this guy's name is Tom Cruise, and he actually does teach well. He's not inexpensive, but he does really teach people really, really well. There is my friend Daniel G. He does not charge a lot for his sales training, but it's all common sense. All of his sales training is common sense. And, you know, he's very good at it. And he helps people get out of their own way. Half the problem is getting out of your own way to do it. I mean, you want to learn real estate? Go out and buy a real estate book. You know? I mean, I always tell guys that I talk with, buy Robert Allen. Robert G. Allen's book, Nothing Done. The concepts still work today. Just go and read it, you know, or get it on Audible. You know, it works. And what people don't want to do is they're just afraid to try. So what if you fail 50 times? Okay? What if you fail 50 times and then that 51st time you succeed? I believe the light bulb was invented on the 1,001st try or something.
Yeah, I believe so. Yeah.
So had Thomas Edison not, right? Was Thomas Edison?
Yeah, Thomas Edison. I think it was like 10,000 times he took him to.
Had he not kept on trying, then we'd be still burning candles or, you know.
Yeah.
Of course not. Someone would have figured it out. But, you know, it's just, it's sad that people, they give up on their dreams, and their dream is right there. It's just right there when they've had that failure. It's right in front of them, and they have to just pick themselves up and get going. So, like, you know, the mere act of falling, when you fall on your face, you're still falling forward. You're still moving forward, even though you fell on your face. So you've progressed. Get up. Come on.
Yeah.
If you don't have that internal drive to get up for the people that you love, do it for yourself. Yes. Do it for someone that you haven't met, because you're going to change their life if you succeed. And stop. I hate this. Everybody always, I need it today. Everybody is always frustrated with what they don't have.
Yeah.
Stop thinking like that. Go out and get what you want. Go out and take it. Go out and make it happen. That's my frustration.
Yeah.